people will ask why we do a virtual anatomy here rather than the old cadaver-based system. And as a practicing physician, I've practiced medicine for over 35 years. I graduated from medical school, or started medical school 40 years ago. So that in medical school, we spent 200 hours dissecting a cadaver. And I can tell you that as a non-surgeon, most of that I've forgotten. Most of what I do these days is look at CT scans and x-rays and radiographs to tell me about the anatomy of my patients. This is an example of how powerful this table is. Here, this teacher can be beside this and actually can start to focus in on different parts of that appendix so that you see the orderly cells. You can get down to the point where you're seeing actual chromatin or DNA. Transition from cadaveric anatomy to x-ray anatomy is very difficult for most people. So that we're using these tables as a way to show what the anatomy looks like in three dimensions based on a CAT scan. For most people, that's hard to understand where all those things are. So the power of this table is we can change that into a 3D rendering from that x-ray, which then allows us to move the head in three dimensions. We can turn it. You can see that there's more to this skull fracture. There's a fracture here. There's a fracture in the jaw. And if we wanted to look at that from the inside, we can actually dissect away the skull and rotate it so we can see the actual skull fracture. The tables serve as a way for us to teach very important things to students. The first thing is that they need to learn the anatomy in a way that they're going to be using for the rest of their lives. Secondly, they need to understand how the radiology that they're going to be doing as part of their evaluation fits into the anatomical process. And the third thing it does is it causes them to become better adult learners, because they not only have to learn it just for 2 months while they learn anatomy, they have to learn it in the setting of their entire medical career.